Hello. Back in previously published instruction cake, I mentioned that we can use the same technique to make many different sculptures. So today let's look deeper in these matters. Inflate balloons leaving about 3-inch flat tails. For example, we're going to make a surfboard. Tie nozzles of both balloons in one knot. I want to use just two balloons for this sculpture. So the size of this surfboard is gonna be very small, a toy size. Okay, let's twist the first blue about 3-inch bubble. Now twist the first pink about 3-inch bubble. Lock free end of the first bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the second blue about 3-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first two blue bubbles in one lock twist. You have to force the second blue bubble between the first blue and the first pink bubble as to make the bird body fold. We have made the front part of the board. Twist the third blue about 1-inch bubble. Twist the fourth blue about 3-inch bubble. Twist the second pink about 1-inch bubble. Lock the free end of the second pink bubble with the free end of the fourth blue bubble. Twist the third pink about 3-inch bubble. Lock the free end of the third pink bubble between the last two blue bubbles. Again, we do it as to make the bird body twist or bird body fold. Both sides of the board looks alike. In this fashion, we're going to make the rest of the board. Basically, we make this fabric simply by repeating the same segments. Each segment has two bubbles, 1-inch bubble and 3-inch bubble. Instead of 3-inch bubble, we can twist any size bubble. For example, here I twist this bubble about 4-inch size. And so I have to twist about 4-inch bubble on the reverse side of the board. So far we have made 3 segments. I'm going to first play this part of the video. Alright, with regards to the instruction cake. Over there we used 6 balloons to make the sculpture. Also we made an extra bubble in each segment, I think. The extra bubble served two purposes. First of all, it helps to fix bubbles in proper positions. And secondly, it's easy to connect balloons to each other with the extra bubble. You don't have to do the bird body fold. Alright, now let's go back to our sculpture here. If you want to make a longer piece of fabric, all you have to do is just attach the new balloon as soon as you run out of balloons, right? I think I have made long enough piece of fabric, so I'm going to finish it now. I want to make the rear part of our sculpture in the same fashion as we did the front part. I will make it pink, just for change. So I twist the 3-inch pink bubble and then lock both ends of the chain of the last two 3-inch pink bubbles in one lock twist. I use two colors in this sculpture, so we actually can use color patterns. Well, we'll talk about it in a bit. Cut off the rest of the balloons, tie off the ends. You can use scissors to cut balloons. Hide the ends between bubbles. Congratulations, we have made the doll size surfboard. It takes just a couple seconds to change the color pattern of our sculpture. Color patterns open many more uses for this kind of fabric. Color patterns very useful to make flags. As you can see, the fabric is quite flexible. It also sturdy because it's double-sided. We can use it to make reinforced walls for big sculptures or even full-size furniture if you wish. Here I made a zigzag pattern. Now I'm gonna turn it back to one side, one color pattern. As I said, it takes just a second to change the color pattern in this sculpture. Really cool. We can quite easily convert our surfboard to a board with wheels. It could be a scooter, a skateboard, or a car. In this example, I'm going to use black balloon to make wheels. Tweeze the first soft about 4-inch bubble, tweeze the second soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock all ends of both bubbles in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon. We have made a wheel. Make as many wheels as you need. We can attach wheels to the board in a different ways. For example, we can force the wheel bubbles between bubbles of the board on the bottom side of the board. Something like that. Maybe I should use smaller size bubbles to make the wheel. Also, we can attach the wheel bubble to the side of the board. Here again, I use a black 1-inch bubble as an extra bubble to attach the wheel and to fix the wheel in a proper position. To make this sculpture look more like a car, you can use one or more balloons to make the top of the car, the cabin. My 3-year-old son recognized this sculpture as a car even without a cabin. Just board with four wheels works well for him. I'm going to leave the sculpture without cabin. It wasn't the purpose of this instruction anyway. We'll have to work some more with use of the fabric. I want to share with you today a couple more examples of what we can do with this kind of fabric. Alright, here's a board with four wheels. Let's call it skateboard or a car. Now pay attention, we used three bubbles to make the front part and three bubbles to make the rear part of the sculpture. We can make it with two bubbles as well. In first example, we tie nozzles of two balloons in one knot. Our next sculpture, we're going to make a board with open ends. Twist the first blue about 4-inch bubble, lock the free end of the first blue bubble with the nozzle of the yellow balloon. Twist the first yellow about 4-inch bubble and lock the free end of the yellow bubble with the nozzle of the blue balloon. That's it, we have made the open end of the board. The rest of the sculpture we twist in the same fashion as we did the previous sculpture. I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. In this example, I'm gonna twist all large bubbles of the same size. Again, I'm using two colors in this sculpture, blue and yellow. And I'm making the color pattern. Making sculpture with open ends give us more options of what we can do with the sculpture. It's kind of obvious, nevertheless, I want to point on it. We can make many pieces of this fabric in advance and then quickly assemble it to make big sculpture. In this example, the open end is not really open. It happens because I use relatively short bubbles to make the sculpture. If we use a larger size bubbles to make the sculpture, then instead of a board, it would look like a pipe. Well, maybe not so much as a pipe, not exactly round shape in diameter. Nevertheless, it would be a hollow inside of the sculpture. Alright, let's put two sculptures next to each other to see the difference. Here, if you take a look from the side, then you'll see the difference right away. I want to point again, this fabric is very sturdy and flexible at the same time. We can bend it in different shapes easily. For the next example, I use two green balloons to make a pyramid, or we can call it a Christmas tree. I start the sculpture with open end and then increase the size of large bubbles gradually, starting from 2 inch and going up, I guess, 7 inch. Now we can turn the pyramid upside down to make a bucket or a bag. In this example, I start the sculpture with 5 inch size bubbles, gradually increasing it. We can use this sculpture as a bag, a basket, or handbag. We can use the same balloons to make the handles. I'm going to add one more segment or one more level to the fabric. In this fashion, we can attach new balloons to the sculpture and make it really big size if you want. We can use this sculpture as it is, fill it up with small sculptures of flowers, for example. Alright, let's use one more balloon to make the handle. Tie ends of the balloon to the basket. If you want, you can bend the handle balloon in the shape of a heart. I'm gonna leave it as it is. Alright, I hope you got better idea what we can do with this kind of fabric. Today we have made just a couple things: a basket, a pyramid, and a board. Different kind of boards. Have fun and happy twisting!